Buenas noches, bienvenidos a este encuentro post partido de los Leones del Escogido. Esta noche tenemos a nuestro dirigente Dave Jaus. Good evening, Mr. Jaus.
Hola.
Thank you for sharing these minutes with us tonight. Tenemos la primera de Jordaniel Abreu. Adelante, Jordaniel.
Buenas noches, Michael. Good evening, Dave. Joe Dunham left the game in the top of the ninth inning. What happened to him? He resigned from the little annoyance he had, or something new?
A little tightness in his leg. He's had it off and on. It's from a lot of playing. A lot of innings, a lot of hours on the field. And he felt it a little bit running on the base hit when he was at first base and went to second. And he limited his explosion, moved over to third, and it started tightening up and had to make a play on the ball thrown by Martes. And he just felt that he wanted to stop it early enough so it didn't become an injury.
La pregunta de Jordaniel es sobre la salida del partido de Joe Dunham. Y dice que tuvo una molestia en la pierna en un momento del partido, que eso limitó su explosividad y que es natural por él haber estado jugando la gran cantidad de partidos, de entradas que ha estado en acción durante la temporada, pero que vamos a revisar qué está sucediendo con él para ver de qué magnitud es esta lesión, pero que se tomó la decisión de sacarlo del partido porque se había visto limitado, sobre todo en sus movimientos, en su explosividad, literalmente. Rafael Padilla tiene una pregunta.
Rafael Padilla, Prensa Deporte y Team Deportivo RD. Bueno, se le fue el partido de las manos. Quiero saber qué confianza le tienen ahora al bullpen después de un partido como el de hoy.
We lost the match in the last inning, basically, and after this game, are you still trust in our bullpen?
The answer to the second question is yes. I trust everybody that we have out there. Our bullpen has been as good as any in the league. It's one of the reasons we're where we are right now. And we didn't lose the game in the last inning. That's you can take that answer because we did not lose the game in the last inning.
Dice que no perdimos el juego en la última entrada y que definitivamente sí vamos a seguir confiando en nuestro bullpen en lo que resta de temporada. But what happened, Mr. Jaus? We didn't lose in the last inning, but what happened exactly in the home?
Well, when you lose a game, you start with pitch one. Now, they scored runs in the ninth inning, but we didn't score in certain innings. We didn't limit some of the opportunities that they got that maybe we had to use more pitching. So every inning and every pitch counts. They scored runs in the eighth and then the ninth inning. But we lost the game because of some things during the first all the way to the ninth. And guess what? When it was the bottom of the ninth and you're down all those runs and you get the tying run up, that means we fought all the way to the end again. And now we're washing it off and ready to go 1-0 tomorrow.
Dice que todos los innings cuentan, que el partido se pierde desde la misma primera entrada, desde el mismo primer picheo, y hubo cosas que no funcionaron en toda la noche, como el bateo, por ejemplo, que no se pudo generar carreras en los momentos determinados, pero que lamentablemente no se pudo hacer. No es un tema de que se perdió en la novena entrada, sino que varias cosas no funcionaron, y la idea es tratar de hacer lo que nos corresponde en los demás partidos. Jordaniel Abreu, adelante.
El Dave, you moved the pieces. Unfortunately, the game was lost. How much intensity will Dave Jaus show in these last games to come?
If you watch me in the dugout and you ask our players, there's intensity every time. I don't think I change. I'm sure I do a little bit, but not intentionally. We come prepared every day, and that starts early in the day, pre-game, then during the game, and then post-game I get to talk with you. I hope you see my intensity in the post-game too. My intensity includes being emotionally positive all the time. regardless of what the result was, because we get to play this game and enjoy this game and watch these players play so hard and in such a hard, in such a difficult thing to do. And us play the game of baseball, and it's a joy to watch that, and intensity comes with it.
La pregunta de Jordaniel es si vamos a continuar con la misma intensidad en los próximos partidos, y nuestro dirigente dice que la intensidad siempre está ahí, la intensidad de su parte siempre está, y que si se mira al dugout en el medio de los partidos, también se ve la intensidad de los jugadores durante cada uno de los encuentros, y que da gusto, es un placer ver jugar a estos jugadores, a estos peloteros del Escogido, y que eso le motiva a seguir jugando de la manera en que lo está haciendo, y por supuesto, la intensidad pues seguirá ahí para el resto de los partidos. Mr. Jaws, we will play tomorrow against Licey. Do you have some schedule for tomorrow, the pitcher, some plan specifically?
Kubiak starts tomorrow, and he'll go and give us as many shutout innings as he can. We'll score some runs and play really good defense. We'll compete to go 1-0 tomorrow.
Me preguntaba sobre el plan de juego de mañana. Dice que David Kubiak estará lanzando mañana y que la idea es tratar de tener mañana 1-0, contar con nuestro lanzador que nos dé la mayor cantidad de entradas posibles, jugar una buena defensa y tratar de conseguir esa victoria siempre pensando en el 1-0 mañana. Thank you very much, Mr. Jaws, for your time. Gracias a ustedes por haber estado con nosotros en este encuentro. Pasen buenas noches y seguimos conectados en las redes sociales de Escogido Baseball Club. Have a good night.
Have a good night. Thanks, guys.